Lenalidomide is a thalidomide derivative used to treat multiple myeloma and anemia in low to intermediate risk myelodysplastic syndrome. In this video, let's find found. What is lenalidomide? What is lenalidomide used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking lenalidomide? How does lenalidomide work? How to use lenalidomide? What is lenalidomide? Lenalidomide, sold under the brand name Revlimid among others, is a medication used to treat multiple myeloma, smoldering myeloma, and myelodysplastic syndromes. For multiple myeloma, it is used after at least one other treatment and generally with dexamethasone. It is taken by mouth. Lenalidomide was approved for medical use in the United States in 2005. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. What is lenalidomide used for? Lenalidomide is indicated for the treatment of adult patients with multiple myeloma, MM, in combination with dexamethasone. It is also indicated as maintenance therapy in multiple myeloma following autologous hematopoietic stem cell transplantation, auto-HSCT. It is indicated for the treatment of adult patients with transfusion-dependent anemia due to low or intermediate 1-risk myelodysplastic syndromes, MDS, associated with a deletion 5q cytogenetic abnormality with or without additional cytogenetic abnormalities. Lenalidomide is indicated for the treatment of adult patients with mantle cell lymphoma, MCL, whose disease has relapsed or progressed after 2 prior therapies, one of which included bortezomib. In combination with a rituximab product, lenalidomide is indicated for the treatment of adult patients with previously treated follicular lymphoma, FL, or previously treated marginal zone lymphoma, MZL. Contraindication. Pregnancy, sexually active women of childbearing potential, not using 2 forms of contraception. Demonstrated hypersensitivity, e.g., angioedema, Stevens-Johnson syndrome, toxic epidermal acrolysis. Side effects. Risk of infection. This treatment can reduce the number of white blood cells in your blood. Bruising and bleeding. This treatment can reduce the number of platelets in your blood. Anemia, low number of red blood cells. Skin changes. Diarrhea. Sore mouth and throat. Constipation. Feeling sick. Pharmacodynamic. Lenalidomide also mediates indirect antitumor effects via its immunomodulatory actions. It inhibits the production of pro-inflammatory cytokines, which are implicated in various hematologic malignancies. Lenalidomide enhances the host immunity by stimulating T cell proliferation and enhancing the activity of natural killer, NK, cells. Lenalidomide is about 100 to 1,000 times more potent in stimulating T cell proliferation than thalidomide. Due to its anti-inflammatory properties, lenalidomide has been investigated in the context of inflammatory and autoimmune diseases, such as amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. Mechanism of action. Lenalidomide directly exerts antitumor effects by inhibiting the proliferation and inducing apoptosis of tumor cells. Lenalidomide triggers the activation of proapoptotic caspase 8, enhances tumor cell sensitivity to FAS-induced apoptosis, and downregulates ANPB, an anti-apoptotic protein. Independent of its immunomodulatory effects, lenalidomide mediates anti-angiogenic effects by inhibiting angiogenic growth factors released by tumor cells, such as vascular endothelial growth factor, VEGF, basic fibroblastic growth factor, BFGF, and hepatocyte factor. In vitro, lenalidomide inhibits cell adhesion molecules such as ICAM1, LFA1, beta-2, and beta-3 integrins, as well as gap junction function, thereby preventing metastasis of malignant cells. Half-life. In healthy subjects, the mean half-life of lenalidomide is 3 hours in the clinically relevant dose range, 5 to 50 milligrams. Dose. Myelodysplastic syndromes. Indicated for transfusion-dependent anemia due to low or intermediate 1-risk myelodysplastic syndromes, MDS, associated with a deletion 5q cytogenetic abnormality with or without additional cytogenetic abnormalities. 10 mg per day, treatment is modified based upon clinical and laboratory findings. Continue treatment until disease progression or unacceptable toxicity. Multiple myeloma. Treatment. Indicated in combination with dexamethasone for treatment of multiple myeloma, MM. 25 grams PO/Q-day on days 1 to 21 of repeated 28-day cycles, use with dexamethasone. Ineligible for auto-HSCT, continue until disease progression or unacceptable toxicity. Dexamethasone schedule. 40 mg POQ-day on days 1 to 4, to 12, and 17 to 20 of each 28-day cycle for first 4 cycles, then 40 mg POQ-day on days 1 to 4 every 28 days. Age greater than 75 years, 20 mg POQ-day on days 1, 8, 15, and 22 of each 28-day cycle. Maintenance. Indicated as maintenance therapy for MM following autologous hematopoietic stem cell transplantation, auto-HSCT. Initiate after adequate hematologic recovery, i.e., ANC greater than or equal to 1000/mCl and or platelets greater than or equal to 75,000/mCl. Starting dose, 10 mg POQ-day continuously, i.e., day 1 to 28 of repeated 28-day cycles, until disease progression or unacceptable toxicity. After 3 cycles, may increase dose to 5 mg POQ-day if tolerated. Hematopoietic stem cell mobilization should occur within 4 cycles of a lenalidomide-containing therapy. Mantle cell lymphoma. Indicated for MCL in patients whose disease has relapsed or progressed after 2 prior therapies, one of which included bortezomib. 25 mg POQ-day on days 1 to 21 of repeated 28-day cycles. Treatment is modified based on clinical or laboratory findings. Continue until disease progression or unacceptable toxicity. Follicular lymphoma or marginal zone lymphoma. Treated in combination with a rituximab product for treatment of patients with previously treated follicular lymphoma, FL, or marginal zone lymphoma, MZL. Rituximab 375 mg per square meter 4q week in cycle 1, days 1, 8, 15, and 22, on day 1 every 28-day cycle from cycles 2 to 5. Lenalidomide 20 mg POQ-day on days 1 to 21 every 28 days up to 12 cycles. Refer to prescribing information for rituximab for dosing. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category, not assigned. Risk summary, based on its mechanism of action and findings from animal studies, this drug can cause embryo-fetal harm when administered to a pregnant female and is contraindicated during pregnancy. That's all the information about lenalidomide we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.